I think part of the reason we survived is that we don't take any shit from anybody. We wanted to be our own persons, do our own thinking, and make our own decisions, and a lot of times it cost us.
When we started the record off, we had some pretty precise plans on particular songs, styles. We had to go back and research and listen to records from the 70s, disco records, Fleetwood Mac records. We listened to all kinds of stuff that we traditionally wouldn't just put on in our cars, you know, and listen to. Actually, the title Risk for this album is about as fitting as it gets.
I was sort of surprised when I came into the band last year that hearing them talk about what they wanted to do, they really wanted to do stuff that was really a far departure from what the band had been doing in previous albums. So, sort of exciting, I think.
When I go to produce a record, if I say, hey, would you mind trying to play something like this? Usually, you see people go, I don't play that instrument, I don't feel comfortable doing that. Guys in Megadeth are like, hey, bring it on. We don't care what it is. If you can tune it like a guitar, we'll play it. So they show up at the studio and you want to try anything crazy, they're game. They push the limits.
Right now, you see the majority of the metal bands went the way of death and black metal and doing the rah, rah, and it sounds like the Cookie Monster's their front man. We kind of went the way of heavy metal, hard rock, which is more, the new wave of British heavy metal meets the British invasion with bands like the Beatles and Led Zeppelin and the Stones and stuff like that, stuff that's really melodic but still, heavy to some degree.
I think there's songs that people who would never even contemplate buying a Megadeth CD are going to hear some of this stuff and go, this is pretty interesting, maybe we should check this out.
I appreciate being able to put a very unrealistic, ironic twist onto words, because neology is something that, for me, is inspiring. Getting another way to get a point across without it being so obvious.
When I stepped in, we started an idea that Dave was going to be a singer now. And the process was, it was interesting. I can't say it wasn't painful at all. Dave is the kind of guy, he walks into the studio and you say, Dave, you gonna warm up your voice? And Dave looked at me like, what? Huh? I said, you gonna warm up, do some vocal exercises. He grabbed a waist back and he went, okay, I'm ready. And that was it.
Artist makes an album and tries to sell it and goes on tour and tries to sell tickets, that's a risk, because the music business is always changing and it's very, very fickle business. People might not like us anymore.
Fickle.
It's fickle,
fickle.
Man. Fickle. We might be history tomorrow, or we might be gods, we'll be one or the other.
I see them as a band that just continues to push boundaries, will not be defined by a label. They're one of the only bands that has survived in the last 10 years. I mean, from the 80s. I mean, they initially started in the 80s. And all the bands on the VH1, where are they now, Joe? Not in Megadeth.
I don't think we're trying to suggest that anybody lash out at things instead of look inward to find out what the real problems are with themselves. It's so easy to blame your parents and to blame society and to blame somebody for your own inability to cope with things. And the only thing that we would appreciate our fans getting from the music is that, you know, become proactive and not reactive.